It is now 7 o'clock. I'd like to call to order the Charter Township of Oxford's Zoning Board of Appeals regular meeting for Monday, September the 12th, 2016. Everyone please stand to pay respects to the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. The recording secretary, please note the roll.
Noted.
Moving on, approval of the agenda. The motion, please, to approve tonight's agenda.
Motion to approve tonight's agenda.
Second.
Moved and seconded. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Moving on to the approval of our minutes for our August 15th meeting. There was one typo at the bottom of page one. The applicant has installed a total of blah, blah, blah signage. It says on, it should be of, square feet of signage, not on signage. Any other comments? Seeing none, I take a motion to approve it, the minutes.
A motion to approve the minutes.
Second that.
Motion and seconded. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Moving on to item number six, public comment for any items on tonight's agenda. Not on tonight's agenda. Seeing none, we'll move on to our regular business. This is ZBA 007.16 signage. Parcel ID 04-22-101-003. 925 North Oxford Road, doing business as Legacy Center. The owner and applicant is Christian Mills. Address 8118 Indianwood Road, Lake Orion, Michigan, 48362. The subject property is located in a C2 General Commercial Zoning District, located on the west side of Lapeer Road, across from Myers. The approval of the application as submitted will require a variance in accordance with Zoning Ordinance 67A, Article 9.8J, wall signs in a residential, non-residential districts. If you recall, we did postpone this from our last meeting. What I would like to do is to bring Mr. Mills up, have him explain to us what he's presented to us in the plans, give the opportunity for us to ask some questions. Since there is new information, I will open up a public hearing, just for the sake of having a public hearing, since there is new information, and then we'll come back to us to decide what we're going to do. Good enough? Mr. Mills, the floor is yours.
Thank you. Good evening. Looking forward to trying to come to a good resolution on this matter and move forward. So thank you for all coming in. Beautiful night tonight. Hard to come in for a meeting. So we had sent you the elevations, and what I wanted to do is just review the requests from the last meeting. From what I understood, really the concerns were making sure that we didn't have carte blanche to just, you know, paint anywhere we like. So we were asked to do elevations with the existing imagery, and also paint some boxes above potential tenant spaces and what we are requiring to finish the building. And this way, you know, if this is approved in its entirety, you kind of know what the restrictions are, we know what the restrictions are, and we can both anticipate future businesses will have to live with those areas that are outlined in this elevation. So I think that's my understanding. Am I accurate?
Yes, that was the direction we gave for you from our last meeting.
Correct. Okay. So I think I've done that.
I would agree.
And I will turn it back to you for questions. Mr. Banachowski?
Yes.
Had given us some notes. I can't read all of the notes. They're a little faint.
Yeah, we can go over it, yeah.
If you don't mind, I'd like to do a few things first before you get into your issues.
Right.
Question for you. Last time you were in, the total signage request was 6,936.16 square feet. And if I read the table, now it's 11,876. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. Do you have a set of plans in front of you, Mr. Mills?
Yes.
On page A200, top of the page, between sign A and sign B, there's a dashed area. There's an open box there. Is that to be a sign? That's between the, it's to the west, or excuse me, to the left of the O sign. There's a dash box on there. See it? Is that a sign, or is that just a mistake?
No, the when we put the front doors in, it actually took out the rest of the Yo Club emblem. So
what I'm specifically asking about is this box.
Oh, I'm sorry. That's a window.
That's a window? Okay, that's not to be in signage?
That's correct.
Okay. Oh, okay. It appears there is a double labeling. If you go to T in the middle image, all the way to the right, and you go to the image on the bottom, it says U. I think that's supposed to be T as well. You see what I'm getting at?
Yeah.
Yeah, that window, I mean, that signage.
It's showing a window between T and U, though.
They're supposed to be multiple.
Well, I think T and U are the same. That's what I'm getting at. I think you just double counted. Because if you look, at the middle image.
Okay.
And you see the two windows with the signs R and S?
Yes.
Okay, then you got the door with the side light.
Yes.
Now go down to the image on the bottom, all the way to the left.
Okay.
You got that window again, and you got the door and the side light. I think they're counting them twice.
Yeah.
I think that U is T.
They are. If you look at the key plan, it shows.
Yeah, I think, yeah. I think you're right.
It's labeled.
It's housekeeping.
Twice.
I want to make sure we all understand each other on the deal.
Yes.
Okay. Let's go to A201 and go to elevation 2, which is the one all the way to the right to the top.
Okay.
AF, is that to be signage, imagery? What is that to be? It says signage. I just
blank space.
That's for Splash Swim School. So it was designed to be, you know, signage.
Signage, written wordage, and things like that?
Yeah.
So everything you have here is signage, is to be written, text, anything you don't know what it's going to be?
Wait, I don't know what it's going to be.
Okay. It's a little disconcerting, but we'll get through that, I think, somehow. 202. This is the west elevation facing the condos and Lake Duels, right?
Yes.
Okay. And same question related to the on the top elevation, AO, AP, AQ, AR, A, are those signage or imagery? What is that?
My guesstimate would be one would be signage and the rest would be imagery. So that's undeveloped space. And
okay.
So it just depends on, you know, if tenants, if one, it could be one tenant that takes that entire space, and it could be just one image, or, you know, they could be broken up into individual.
And then the bottom elevation with AU, I see that's all one band at 2,000 square feet?
Yes.
It's a lot of signage.
Yeah, and to be honest with you, the visual on that was supposed to be in accordance with, you know, the swim school. So they had some ideas of doing something pretty unique there, but just tasteful, so it's not blaring into, blaring into the condos. But I think that there was a talk about adding, like, you know, a couple of fish there, and, you know, just the idea of something swimming. But
That's the blue wall, right?
Yeah, that blue wall.
That's the entire length of the blue wall?
The blue wall is supposed to be, you know, represent the ocean. That's why you have two colors there, and
okay,
they would fill that out.
All right.
So it's imagery, not signage?
It would be imagery, yes.
That is my comments. Mr. Bailey, you have anything?
How many signs do we have versus how many tenants?
Yeah, my question was how many tenants are there?
I mean, does each tenant have a sign? Do they have duplicates?
No, you mean, well, so we have the list of all the current tenants here.
Mm-hmm.
And everything's a little unique. Like for example, Soothe Your Soul will just take over probably the yoga image and it'll be a sign, correct? So she would only have her, you know, her logo on the building. I really think that for the most part, you know, tenants moving in will just have their logo on the side of the building. You know, with the exception of what we have already discussed.
Any questions? Questions? Comments?
So we have a total of 41 logos and signs, with the exception of you, which would bring it down to 40. Is that right?
Well, no. It's really hard for me to comment on that. My preference really is to use imagery to represent multiple tenants. So, you know, unless you buy an outside wall or something like that, then the tenants on the inside, you know, we're not putting their logos on the outside of the building. So to represent multiple tenants, we're doing some imagery. It's just not planned yet because we don't know. We don't know how to fill out the rest of the building or who's coming in.
So you labeled it, I think I said 41, but 51 on here, right? But I think we're saying that you is a duplicate?
Yes.
Yeah, so there's 50.
So there's 50? Are you going, is that right?
Yeah, we double 50 is your double counting would be 50. I just counted those.
That's correct. And all these blank spaces are not logos.
It's either a logo or a sign, right?
Correct.
And are we including logos as potential signs? Or yeah. Signs? I mean, any of these murals, as I would call them?
Yeah, they're all labeled.
So it would be either a mural or a sign for their business.
Right, sign for the business, right.
Yeah. When I say logo, that's what I mean.
Any other questions? Actually, I see more than 51 here, because if I look at each individual line, each one of these letters on here, that could be potential for business signs, if not a logo already. But that's a total of logos and signs is more than 51 if you just count through each individual line. And right now my assumption is because you have something, a letter or of some sort attributed to these other things here, even though you're saying blank, it's all potential for you to do more just to fill out this entire page. So I have to say there's more than 51 offhand.
But ultimately what will happen is, and I'll give you an example, we have, someone wants to come in and do 12,000 square feet, so we wouldn't, you know, decorate the entire wall for one activity.
Right.
So what we've tried to do is accommodate ourselves in the future that, you know, if someone breaks up a space, you know, or if something is split, so maybe, you know, we have an area to be able to put something that represents, you know, their activities appropriately.
So I'll be writing you a blank check then to change whatever you needed when you wanted to, depending upon who a new tenant would be or...
Within the confines.
Was to show us the ultimate. What is the ultimate? So we all understand what we're signing off on, what we are potentially agreeing to.
Right.
So this doesn't have to become a code enforcement issue.
Right.
Where, well, we thought, we kind of talked, we saw it, our understanding was we wanted it in black and white is what we wanted. So we have a living, breathing document.
So actually we got gray right now from the way I look at it. Not exactly black and white, but a combination of the two. Because it's still to say they could put something up that wouldn't be appealing to the eye, but we'd already give them the blank check to put what they wanted only because of square footage.
But I think the direction was to put wherever they wanted to put something to indicate where.
Okay.
And that, I guess, that's what I read into what we asked.
That's what we asked them to do.
Elevation and square footage.
Yep.
Yeah.
Take a long look, look in the future, and tell us what it's going to be.
Yeah.
So are you looking for, I mean, back to the original question on tenants, are you looking for this 50 tenants? One per sign or double?
No, I don't.
What are the tenants? Because, you know, our ordinance is directed towards tenants and square footage.
Yeah.
So I'd like to clarify that.
There won't be 50 tenants in that building. How many tenants do we have now?
Can I clarify that? I thought the ordinance
9.8J1
was one sign for each tenant with an individual access.
Yes.
And then...
Mm-hmm. Well, it was a hybrid.
It's capped at 150 square feet, too, right?
But that's with the individual access. And then if they share an access, then there's another calculation that goes to that. It's not my assumption that you take the number of tenants and each one gets 150. It's tenants with an individual access. Then there's a secondary calculation. That was my question, because that's what I want to find out. The variance would be based on that number. And the planning report's kind of, it just says basically 150 per tenant, but I don't think that's the whole thing. It was 9.8J1, right?
Number one. Permanent wall sign shall be permitted for a building on each parcel. In the case of multi-tenant or shopping center, one wall sign shall be permitted for each tenant having an individual means of public access.
Yeah.
Tenants who occupy a corner space of a multi-tenant structure shall be permitted to have one sign on each side of the building. Where there are several tenants using a common space, a common entrance, in a multi-tenant structure, only one wall sign shall be permitted. But the total wall sign should be allocated on the basis, equal basis by all tenants.
Yeah, so the 150 feet gets shared by the number of people that share that entrance.
Yes.
Okay, that's how I read
that's,
it.
That's the way the ordinance reads. You're correct.
Well, and one of the discussions that we had during our presentation is this is definitely a hybrid. So you can't put it in either one of those buckets.
Any other questions?
How many? I guess I want to break down the numbers again because it's not on the minutes. And so I'm going to ask a lot of the same questions that we had last time. How many individual tenants do you have currently? Well, let's put it this way. How many individual units do you have approved for tenants? Because you may not have a tenant if you have a, you might have a ability to put one in, you just don't have one yet. And then you could break down out of those which ones have their own entrance and which ones share. The reason I do is we need to know that because our variance is based on that number.
But it is a hybrid because they're, and I can go through the, we counted them before. There are 19. Okay, so there are 19 tenants in the building.
Okay.
Okay. When you say open, you mean like what spaces that we could have? Okay, so there are 19 tenants, and again, it isn't a shopping mall, so there isn't a 2,000 square foot unit with a door. You know, we may have pre-built, I'll give you an example, I've got 920 square feet, and you know, another one that's 1,100 square feet, another one that's 2,800 square feet. So I could say those could be three units, but I also have one person who's talking to us about taking all three of those spaces. So I don't have an answer for you. It's not black and white. You know, as people come to us and as we are selective in that process and based on their space requirements and, you know, this Tetris, you know, Rubik's Cube, we're trying to fit them. So to answer your question, as far as the number of entrances we have.
You want to count that for me?
So you want to know the number of tenants that have an individual entrance? Is that
The ordinance asked for that, but we could also, we really should know which ones have their own entrance, and then I would assume that the rest all kind of share the rest of the entrances, which kind of makes what you say, you'll have some that have their own. I would imagine the swimming would have to have their own entrance just because there's a pool and things
That's
like
correct.
That. So which ones have just their own, and then how many number of doors are left would kind of tell us which ones share the others. I would assume that would be reasonable.
For the 19 that we have, but it doesn't really address, you know, what will happen in the future moving in. But, you know, I can, do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, so you have 19 now. How many more would you predict? You know how much space is left?
There's about...
Assuming you went with it like the smallest available, how many do you think?
It really, I can't answer that. There's about 45,000 square feet left.
Okay.
And so it could be three tenants.
And how much is utilized?
Of the 43,000 square
feet? No, a total. You said 40. There's 45,000 approximately square feet left.
Yeah, so I think, you know, outside of common areas, it's... probably 15,000 square feet. So, there's probably about 130,000, 140,000 square feet.
Is utilized now or total? Mm-hmm.
Utilized now.
So it's approximately, what, 190,000 square feet total?
It's 208,000.
208, okay. So, and then, yeah, you have your commons area and your hallways and
yeah.
Okay, so your 20% on that. Really great. 80. What's 76%?
That sounds about right.
Full.
Mm-hmm. That's just doors.
And then in terms of entrances, did you guys count? You can use my, if you want to. It would be anyone that would be used by the public, so you wouldn't be able to count like a private entrance, but any of the public. If you want to use my elevations, you can probably just count off those.
There's 39 doorways, what I counted up, but how many are actual entrances or how many are fire doors?
Plus public, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, what? How many entrance and exits?
She'll count it.
Can we... If you're going to do that, can you get up on the mic, please?
I would say any entrance that could be used for public.
And could you
I would count anyone that the public could use.
For an individual business or for multiple businesses?
Just to get into the facility, the entire 208.
For public use, I think we're looking for.
So there are three major entrances into the building.
Mm-hmm.
And then there are...
so far 11 out of 19
so there are
11 of 19 so far that have individual entrances.
Okay.
Because there's a lot more doors, but not all of them might be public.
Yeah. And of those 11 of the 19, how many already have their own murals up or signs?
Well,
it would be eight.
Probably half of them, right?
Sorry.
When you say
seven,
just to clarify, you're talking about the imagery, or you're talking about like a logo or
either one,
a sign.
Of the 11, you said there's 11 of 19
that have individual entrances.
Okay.
And then six of the 19 are going to have
their own.
Six of the 11 are going to have their signage up.
So we still have six more murals or signs to go up, plus potentially, what, four or five more?
And that's not including the businesses that aren't, those aren't including the spaces that aren't occupied.
I'm trying to just get a basis of what we
right.
start our, if we assume there was 11 public doors,
mm-hmm.
each of that 11 would be allowed 150.
Right.
that comes out to the 1650.
I don't even know why we're having this discussion at this point. The final site plan has not been approved. They could put doors in anywhere they wanted. They could do what they want up until that point. Right now we're talking about something that is theoretical. That's my opinion.
Well, we're boxing in what the building is, you know, to accommodate.
You've created this hybrid thing on your own accord because you haven't had any final PC approval on this particular building and what's going in. So you can continue to metamorphosize and create things and move things around to your pleasure right now. I'm not in favor of that. I'm not in favor of you putting up all these murals on your own. Don't misunderstand me. I love them. I think it's all great. But if there's anyone of all these wonderful people who signed off about how much they love this building and all the murals on it, you got hundreds and hundreds of signatures here. If any one of these good people decided to go and put up a garage or to move a wall or a foundation or put an addition on, we'd be all over them in no time. And here you've come in, you've changed things, we've had to change the zoning on it. You continue to do what you want. I do not like the fact that you come in back door on this whole thing the entire way.
Well, Larry, with all due respect, you know, the process of approval, and if you and I sat down with how this started, nobody did what they wanted to do. There was a lot of approval and a lot of support in the beginning. Do you think I put a $10 million project together and just went ahead and did it without approval? I mean, do you really think I did that? So things have manipulated and changed throughout this entire process, all the way. So I didn't just build a building hoping that somebody at the end would say, sure, this looks good.
Yeah, well, right now, I'm just interested in murals and signage alone. I mean, everyone can get into everything else, but my bottom line at the end of this ruling is going to be, did you do it in a proper manner? And does it fit the description of what we have in our plans?
Yeah, we can only act. I know this plan commission is still an active item for them to approve a site plan. There are things that have come before us that have not had site plan approval before. We are to look at what is in front of us.
Right.
That's our mission on this board, is to do that. So what's presented?
Yeah, so I know.
And what I think what Ms. Riser is trying to do is we're trying to just get a basis. That's all. Understanding what is the true variance that we are given or giving or choose to give. And so we have that basis and we understand it. And number two, I think we also need to do a little bit of a deeper dive and find out and specify specifically what going forward is going to be imagery, what is going to be a mural imagery, whatever you want to call it, and then that is set in stone, and then what is going to be signage, and that is set in stone. That's where I would like to take.
Yeah, what I was trying to do is
correct me if I'm wrong.
No,
other board members, I think that's where we truly want to go.
Move and well, I mean, I need to know a firm number of what they'd be allowed, because that's my basis. Is what if everything was conforming on equal footing with other businesses?
So you're saying that you said there's 11 doors that you counted.
So that's where I came up with there was 11 19. Doors.
Well, there was a comment earlier. There's 19 tenants.
There's 19 tenants.
Yeah.
Yeah, but the ordinance goes by how many share unique doors. So giving the benefit to the applicant for the most would be allowed, assuming everybody had their own entrance, that would be 11 signs that would be allowed. Now, we know that some share, so it would actually be less, but still giving the benefit of the doubt with 11, you know, with 11 doors.
So we're basing it on today's numbers and the paperwork we have in front of us. Nothing
right.
Hypothetical out there for the future and what could be because of little dotted lines. Currently have is what we're going to work to. And if they need to come back at a future point to get more approvals, they do that.
Well, I would say that the basis would be 11. If you, I'm just trying to find a starting point. If they were allowed 1,650 based on 11 doors, if they added more doors for individual things, the ordinance would allow them to add 150 square feet.
Yes.
If the entity had its own entrance and serviced it, if they shared, they'd all have to share that 150.
So if there's a modification in the future, there's another tenant, another door.
Still have to comply.
Have to comply with the 150.
The current.
Or whatever the zoning is at that time.
And then you know, going back and forth on a lot of this, I still went, you know, I talked about last time, it's taking that use and what you guys do and the uniqueness of it in balance with the rest and still, you know, trying to make sure that we also are fair to our other businesses that may compete or be in the area and say, well, I want to do that too, and giving them a real unfair advantage, this entity with lots of what I would consider clear signage would be anything that would be wording to what that business is, and that's a sign. The murals themselves, I think, are aesthetically matching the use of the building, and I don't have as much of a problem with the murals. I do have a problem with the signage, anything with the wording on it or a trademark logo, you know, being more than what would be allowed. And so in my mind, I'm separating the two, murals and signage.
Yeah. And we need to, and what we're going to need to know, what I said is, we're going to need to determine what's what. Specify that specifically, that this can be this and only this, right. A mural. This can be a sign, and that's it. I don't know if it would do any benefit to us to walk through all these elevations and determine, number one, doors. What is a door? So we can have that basis. And then, or walk through these and just look each individual item, yes, no. Because I, you know, for instance, I look at R&S on the east elevation. They're above windows. Do that really need to have a sign? You look at, you know, AAA.
I think we're going to have to go through item by item, because you're right. You're going to have one where you got a window and then you have some dotted lines above it or something next to it. And what do we do in a situation like Soothe Your Soul, who has a back door to that suite? I think it's 113. They have a sign out there that says this is for emergency exit only. And do we count that as a door that's operable for people to come in and out, egress? I mean,
it wouldn't be an entrance.
No, it would not be an entrance.
Okay, well, all the rest of those doors lined up in that area are all entrances and exits. So, I mean, who's determining what is and what isn't with that respect? And once it's labeled, does it stay labeled like that?
Yes. Until it's changed, until it becomes a primary entrance.
Okay, and that's going to be up to them, whether they change it or not? I mean, are we going to have any say over that, that you need to come back and verify and show us why you're changing it?
Well, I think as a part of whatever we do, let's say, for instance, we put forward some sort of approval for a variance. Right. I think there should be language in there. Should there be another entrance added that is a primary entrance or right. A main building entrance, that they would be allowed 150 square feet or whatever the signage at the time is approved for.
And was that at the discretion of Soothe Your Soul to label it like that? I mean, we need to probably find some of these answers out.
Actually, yeah, that led me to another question. Do you charge anything for the businesses to put anything on the side of the building?
You mean like rent the space?
Do you charge in any way?
No.
Okay, so there's no, if somebody from inside wants to put the mural on, obviously I'm assuming they'd have to pay for the painting of it, but.
But it's not a, first of all, you know, going back to our earlier presentation, you know, this isn't about having a sign for every business in the building. The advantage of the imagery is that it represents a theme within the building without cluttering the building. So
So those signs that are out there, did those people pay for them? Did those businesses pay for those signs to be put up? Do you gather more money by having them put that on the exterior surface as opposed to...
No.
No?
No. So,
and what kind of differentiation are we going to run into between the actual door itself as opposed to the signage they have up above?
Well, one of the reasons why we put this together was to lock in a space, because none of this meets code, you know, and we have pre-existing conditions that don't allow us to use traditional signage. And so we talk about the level of fairness, or we talk about being able to compete across the street. We can't compete with across the street because we can't have a monument sign, and we can't have certain other signs. So we have to work within the unique confines of this building.
But there are proper steps to take, and that's what I get back to. You should have come in front of the Planning Commission, could have presented some of these images to them. They could have either approved it or not, and then you would have come to us. I hate it when people come back door saying, it's all done, look how beautiful it is, and then they want the approvals.
And Larry, I can see your point of view, and what I can tell you is that we spent, you know, tens of thousands of dollars in architectural drawings, including imagery on the outside, that was brought to the township before we even started this process. So this was not done in a vacuum. I didn't wake up and just paint imagery on the building, okay?
So I understand that, but everyone else can go through the Planning Commission. They can get site approvals. We got a Tractor Supply company who came in, got special permission to store some of their stuff outside as displays and trailers and stuff like that. But they came in and they did it in the right manner. Like I said, I'm going to repeat it. I love the murals. I love what you've done with the exterior of your building. However, coming in back door like that, now we're going to have everyone else. You're going to set precedents out there. And I don't like that. Because now I'm going to have some other guy that's going to come in. He's going to paint his building off and say, oh, look at how nice it is. Then we're going to have to say, oh, okay, well, we gave it to this guy. Now we've got to give it to the other guy.
Right.
And I get tired of that kind of thing happening.
A question that you brought up. You said that you brought to the township with the pictures. Did anyone at the township lead you to believe that those pictures were approved?
Kelly, I don't want to go into all the conversations and who said what in the beginning. You know, the township has treated us very fairly. We've worked with the township hand in hand from day one on this project.
Well,
day one.
Says you cast something out there, and I don't want to leave it hanging because people watch this on cable afterwards.
Yeah, I understand.
So you're not saying you were left with the impression in any distinct way that we had an approval or not an approval for that.
I'm stating that we met with the powers to be before we started this project and had. You know, we weren't required to have full site plan, number one, to start this project. So,
but that also changed when they had to rezone it because of the process which you were doing.
Well, the reason why we had to rezone it was because we were told that it would be under the, you know, the master plan. And so that our business model currently, because of the historical use of that building, you've had dog food companies, you had an auction company, yep. You had gymnastics there, and we were told that that all fit within the master plan. And so as we moved through the process, people decided that needed to change. And so we just went along with that change. So that's the reason why we're standing here. You know, I'm sure there are some things that I could do better. But I'm very respectful of the process and, you know, leave it at that.
I'm just saying I'd hate to think that somebody led you to believe you could. So I don't want to think that that happened, that this is, you're here now. So this is where we're at.
This is a, you know, it is a partnership here. And, you know, what we've done to date, I think has been, you know, very favorable and tasteful. And I love this community as much as each and every one of you here. So we're asking for a little bit of leeway on this process. You know, at the end of the meeting, how we left it was, Christian, look, we understand what's currently there, but let's look at what isn't there and try to estimate what that looks like. So we brought that back to you. I'm happy to go through the empty spaces. If there's some change that needs to be considered, we can do that to try to accommodate any concerns. You know, we really don't want to be in this position moving forward. So
understood. You know, we also, as I said last time, we want to make sure we all understand each other. So there is no issue related to code enforcement. We don't need people spending their time doing that. And I do understand Mr. Banachowski's frustration. I voiced the same thing when we had the last meeting. And we are faced sometimes with people that want to do certain things like that, Larry. I would agree.
I'm curious as maybe poll the members. I know what I said. I'm kind of classifying murals and signage different. And I don't know how everyone else feels. I mean, if that's a dead issue and no one else feels it's different, then I won't even continue to discuss.
To me, signage has the wording in it. So it's, you're going to have soothe your soul. So you're going to have a fuel your life cafe.
Yeah.
I mean, and it's going to be specific wording related to the business. And the mural, it could be generalized. I mean, even though you're going to have the pool there, and that may be up, showing these pictures of different people doing different activities, the paintball. I mean, those are activities you could assume with anything, whether they even had a pool in there or not. If they had some swimming pictures up there just to symbolize, and that's what I'm looking at the murals are, murals as a symbolization of these different activities and not actual signage itself.
Okay.
Now, if you want to correlate that to it, then we can look at it as being signage. But if you want to be, there's nice artwork out there, a mural per se, then that's a little bit of a different story to me. I just don't want to leave you with a blank check right now. No. With all these squares on here. I'd rather have us come in and approve what you currently have, and then until you get the rest of your site plan together and you actually get what's going to be in those spots, then come back to us and we'll say yay or nay to it at the time. I don't want to just give you a blank check, though, with just lots of blank squares out here and you're not quite sure what you're going to do with them.
My opinion was, like, if it had the part of the business name in it, naming or words, or if it had anything that was trademarked,
yeah,
copyrighted.
Yep. So
Bailey, your comments related to Ms. Rosner's comment as far as polling, what your interpretation?
Yeah, I'd like to know the difference between signage and murals, because what I'm seeing here is 23 boxes of various sizes. So which one are going to be advertising a business? Which one is going to be a mural? I mean, 23 new boxes. Do we have 23 new tenants going in, or is this?
Well, that's why I suggested that any of the boxes that are there currently, we don't even include. We just approve what is currently up there. And then if they fill those boxes out later on, they come back to us, we can give another approval to actually what's there. I don't want to give them a blank check to all those boxes.
No, I think that's
what we're just talking about. You know what? What's your opinion of mural and business? I mean, or signage.
Is a mural a signage?
The simple
up front, the lacrosse player, or the football player, or the swimmer, or the golfer. Is that a sign?
No, because it doesn't have wording.
Okay.
I'm going to stop for a second.
But, okay, go ahead.
Mr. Walters, your opinion. We're straw polling here.
On the image.
On a mural. Is it a mural? Is a mural a sign?
According to Wortman, it is.
Yes, but.
So I have to go with what?
Okay.
That statement.
Okay. My opinion, looking at it, I understand what our consultant says. I think a signage is directly related to a business or something that's trademarked, like a Nike logo. We all know what that would be.
Yep.
The imagery, I think, adds to the architectural intrigue of the building. When it doesn't contain words, I don't think it would be, in my mind, construed to be a sign. That's my two cents, so mm-hmm. I think we're somewhat all in concert, except Mr. Walters, but you're entitled to your opinion, of course.
Yep.
Always going strictly by the book.
Right, strictly by the book, and I appreciate that. Now, the challenge before us, and Larry, I understand what you're wanting to do is to take the snapshot of today, grant him what's there today, and in the future he comes back. I would rather look at this, give him the areas that we would like, that's our job here, and we can say yay or nay to, almost walking through, like I said, having to go through, it's going to be time consuming, but to go through every single box that he has here.
Right.
And determine, and you're going to have to make a decision, is it going to be a signage or is it going to be a mural? That's what the questions are for the unanswered.
That's a fair recommendation.
Yeah, I mean, let's go through that exercise.
Do we know how many square feet are in signage right now and not murals? Or should we just go through and identify each one as a mural or a sign? And then
yes, that's what I want to do.
And then we'll know what is required, okay. And then we will know what the variance should be at that point, right?
Yes, fair enough.
Let's do that.
All right, so let's, obviously we understand A is a mural, right? On page 200?
Yes.
Kids jumping.
Give us your best guess.
B, signage.
Yes.
Yes.
That is their logo.
Yep. C, mural.
Mural.
D.
That's a sign.
That's for our distinguished applicant.
D is a sign.
D. D is a sign. E.
So, E will be a sign.
Okay. F is a sign.
Yes.
G is definitely a sign.
G is a sign. H. What is H, Mr. Mills?
H will be a mural.
Okay. I is a mural. J is a mural. K is a mural. L is a sign.
Yes.
M is a mural. N is a mural. O is a mural. P?
Okay, that's not O is not a logo. Trade
nope, type. It's not a logo.
Just sign.
P.
So P, Q, R, S, T, U, like all the way to the end.
Are all signs?
Are all signs.
Okay.
So my assumption then is that with the two windows there, they could be potential doors?
Those are existing doors.
R&S? R&S, I'm assuming, is a window because we've explained that before.
Yes, yep. That's correct.
So there's still potential for doors?
Potentially, yes.
So what about AB?
AB is a sign.
That's also a sign?
Yeah, that's the legacy Ignite sign.
No, there's nothing on it. There's nothing there.
AB, right there.
Yeah, it is.
There's lamp. This says legacy.
Oh, it's still light on.
It's deep in there.
It's hidden in the brick.
Yes. Okay.
So AC.
What do we have for T again?
T is a sign.
T is a sign.
All the way down are signs.
All right. Okay.
All the bounds are signs.
As opposed, all the way to AA.
Yes. All the way to AA.
P to AA.
Yep. P to AA.
Where do we designate this at?
That is nothing. That is not a sign.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Go down 200?
Yes.
All right. 201. Elevation 2. AC. Sign?
Sign.
AD.
Where are we at? We're in front of Splash.
Yep.
Yeah. AD would be mural.
Mural. AE, sign?
Yes.
AF.
Mural.
Okay. All right. AG, obviously mural. The two AGs, don't we?
Nope.
No.
What do we have with these two here? Those all down there? AG?
Yeah. I'm sorry, we're going down here. Get two AGs.
Yep.
Call the AG1, which is the mural.
AH.
AH, yeah.
AH, okay. AH is the kids' energy zone.
Yep.
That's a sign. AI, mural.
Mural.
AJ. AK is a sign. AL, sign.
Yep.
AM, mural. AN, mural. Good. All right, 202, top of the page. AL, mural sign.
Now these are on the back wall.
This is all against the west. This
west
is against
the west side.
Elevation, yep.
Yep.
These are, so I would do AL would be a mural, and AP would be a sign. AQ would be a mural, and AR would be a sign.
What's the public opinion on AP and having signs on the back facing, you know, Waterstone? These people, I've heard from some people who were not on this list.
Okay. Let's get this done, and we're going to have that discussion.
What was AR? Because I'm going to put it on this
AR list. Is a sign.
Okay, thank you.
So AO is a mural, AP is a sign, AQ is a mural, AR is a sign, AS obviously is a mural. AT is a mural. And then AU.
Yeah, AU would be a mural.
One heck of a big mural.
Mr. Walters, can you do me a favor and calculate those?
Yeah.
I can do it.
Well, you got more on 03.
Oh, I got more?
Yeah, you got 203.
All right, one more. 203, Mr. Mills. AV.
Sign.
Sign. AW.
Sign.
AX is mural. AY is mural.
If you can just go quickly through the start and just tell me which of the letters are signs, I can mark it. It'll add a lot quicker.
All right. Signs. B. D. E.
Hold on. B.
E. F. P. Oh, I'm sorry. L. P. Q. R. S. T. V. W. X. Y. Z. Double A. Double B. And there is no U.
No,
U is out.
A, B, not double B.
Got those? Good, Kelly?
What about AC through AO?
No. AC sign. AE sign. AH sign. AK sign.
AL sign.
AP sign. AR sign.
Yeah, I got
that.
You missed AL.
AL is a sign.
AL is a sign.
AL sign is a sign too. Yep.
Okay, now we have a document we can add a lot quicker from.
Okay, yes. I'll let you two mathematicians have at it.
You were looking at me, right?
What do you have for AV and AW?
AV.
Mural for AD and AW as sign.
Why don't I go through one more time?
I have AB as a sign.
No, AV as in
dog.
AD is a mural.
AD is a mural.
What you're, she's saying D. AV is in Victor.
V is in Victor. Okay.
D.
Sign.
Yeah. I have that as a sign.
Yeah, and AW.
I have AW as a sign.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes. Mills, thank you for your indulgence. We're just trying to create a basis for this.
3790. We'll do a double check.
He's doing his math. I'm having our colleagues punching him in here.
Yeah, 2704.
Yeah, 2704?
Please.
What do you have?
He's got 2704.
2704? Got to be over 27 just looking at the numbers from the ballpark.
Compare notes down there. Compare with her. I'm sure we're good.
Tell us if I had the square footage versus variance. That's funny.
I want to ask.
Well, we know what the variance is going to be, right?
I came up with 3790 again. Okay. Throughout this list, because I haven't marked which ones, makes it easier to add. Anything with the line in front of it.
Okay. $37.90.
Now, does that correspond to your print there, to your elevations?
Yeah, we marked all the ones. Those do okay. Core, those core light. So we're good.
Okay, I know he's still adding that up.
Yeah, 3,800.
I think that you might have some mark that are different than what we have.
And yeah,
you're getting.
I added up hers, and I got 3,790. Yeah, I got 3,790. It's based on her marks, not mine. But if you're using the same.
Am I 3,790 the record then of this meeting, or do you want to get something, get the extra 10 square foot somewhere?
To get the extra what?
Was it 3790?
3790. 3800. Yeah, so I don't know if there's a math there in one of these.
3800 is the is what the total sign. All right, total square footage of 3800 is what we're dealing with. Now, if there are quote unquote 11 entrances, right?
Right.
Each entrance would be allowed 150 square feet.
Okay. Correct.
So that would be 1,650 square feet that is allowable. So 3,800 minus 6,550 or 1,650 is 2,150.
Yep.
Is the additional signage that he's requesting.
Now, looking at everything and the purpose of signage and the back of the building, which I have is AO through AY, is that correct?
I'm sorry.
The rear of the building.
The west elevation, you mean?
West elevation, is that AO through AY? I just want to make sure I have my math.
Yes.
Right.
That's page 202.
AO through AY on your signage calculation is 1,022 feet of what you have. I don't really think there's a big necessity to have signage back in the rear of that building for what its faces. This is my own personal opinion. I don't think you're gaining anything in terms of recognition and all the things that you'd be trying to accomplish with the sign. I don't have a problem with the square feet calculations on the rest. If I took that rear signage out of there and said, put a couple good murals in there, he'd be a lot closer to that.
Yeah, you'd be another number. 432 square feet.
Let me just...
With AP and AR?
Make one statement.
If you take out everything from AO, so there's 216, 216, 295, and 255. I think I got that right. That's around 1,000 square feet of signage in the rear that if you remove that as signs, you'd be an awful lot closer to what?
Is this, I'm missing the point here. We were talking about the west elevation, right?
West elevation.
Yeah. Which is, the sign it has there is the AP and AR signage.
Oh, that's why I asked if it was AO through AY. I thought AO, A through...
AO is a mural. AQ is a mural.
Right, but I have 216, 216, 295, and 295.
And the west, in the south.
AO through AY, correct?
North.
Got it.
North. North and west sides of the building you're looking at, right?
It says west.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, so AW and AV, got it.
So that one starts at which one?
This says north?
203, yep, 203, got it.
We're looking at the west side.
This is the north elevation. Yeah. This is
AO through.
Okay.
It was just two of those were signs, though.
We're looking at the lakeside.
AP and AR.
Okay. AP and AR, then.
AV and AR are which on which elevation?
AP.
AP and AR face the west, face the lake, face right. The condos.
That's the west. And so which elevation, I'm asking, are AV, like Victor?
North.
AW.
That's the north side.
Okay, that's the north.
You're going to gain a 982 on the other.
You know, I just want to make a comment on the number of doors. Because you had asked me a question, Kelly, of how many of our tenants had doors. And so we answer that based on the number of tenants. But the number of doors that we actually have is how many?
42.
24.
How many are public access? Or that's what I'm saying.
24 public access.
24.
24 doors.
24.
I counted 42 total on all sides of the building. Is that right?
Public, we're looking at public doors.
So of those, 24 are public access?
Yes.
Meaning they're open during business hours?
Correct.
I think what Kelly was getting to was on the west side where you have the big blue wall, two different colors of blue.
Mm-hmm.
He says you could bring your numbers down closer to what you're allowable for those doors if we didn't put anything up on there. If there were no murals to go on there other than just
about signage.
As is.
Yes.
They should talk about the signage there.
Right. The signs,
not the mural.
Yeah.
She's talking about these signs.
The signs
here,
on the back.
There.
Okay.
Those two signs right there.
Yeah, there's
and the two
at,
signs on the north.
And the signs on the north.
Talking about
the
AV and AW.
Yeah, the north. You know, because you've got traffic coming. It's. I don't know how much they're seeing on that north side from the way the building is set back with the drop and the houses that are right there. I just don't know how visible that is. You've
I'm
got
not
a
as,
lot of exposure on your...
Waterstone.
Yeah, I'm not as opposed to those. I think they need to be a little bit smaller.
Yeah.
That's all. I like to see those at 150. But the one, you know, along the north side,
mm-hmm.
that's my opinion. I agree with the ones in the back. I don't see any value in having signage there. Murals, yeah, I like the idea of murals, but signage, I don't know if that's all that necessary. This, to me, they need to have signage. This, in my mind, they don't, because it's not really, you'd have to drive around the building to find it. I understand the stuff on the south side, I get it. I understand the stuff on the east side, I get it. North side needs to be treated kind of, if we're treating them all similarly.
Then, I guess...
We're not looking at that much in the way of square footage for those other doors, though, are we?
No, I mean, in terms of overall square footage, I'm pretty comfortable with a lot of these. I think the only ones I'd like to really specifically address is we have urban air at 500. We're limiting everybody in this township to 150. Mm-hmm. And this is 500. I think it could be accomplished with something slightly smaller. That's just my opinion. The other one that we have that's pretty large is the energy zone sign. That's not in scale as much of the rest. It's not as huge. It's 260. I guess maybe I'd just like to discuss it and see how everyone else feels, because that one's quite large.
Well, at this point, it's already up. I wouldn't have them take anything down or do anything else with it. But that's my opinion.
Should we have a comment?
I agree with Larry. I mean, I don't want to have them repaint stuff that's there, but I think maybe go to the 150 per entrance, and then any special ones, they can come back for a special variance after the fact for that individual business. If you keep everything consistent at 150.
Yeah, and that was my comment that I made about a potential condition, should we choose to do something in favor here, making that any future signage for a public entrance would be limited to 150 square feet.
Right.
So that wouldn't have to come back in front of us. Now, does that create an enforcement issue?
Well, my concerns are, I'd like to base it on, if we're giving them a variance of extra, if they come in for more, I think that should go off what they've already been done. There should be a justification to add more.
Yeah.
Because you're expanding on it, so it would need to come in as a variance.
Yeah, and then they have the right to do that. Yeah, they always have the right to do that.
All right, and then, God, you said something else a second ago.
I think we're giving you an awful lot here if we do give this to you. So we don't want to see you coming in for more variances. You trying to make adjustments, okay, to what you have out there currently, to all this that we'd be giving you.
I'd like to see some wording in there that when these ones that are quite large are replaced, that they're replaced with the sign we specified. I don't want it replaced with one that's, you know, like say urban air. I don't want it to, my vote wouldn't say, I want whoever's next to have that 500 square feet space. I'd like to see it reduced.
Well, if you give the 150, that's the baseline, and if they want to come in with 500, they come to us for a variance.
Right, that's what I'm saying. What I'm saying is, when I'm saying this one has the 150, it's based on this particular illustration as it's shown. If it changes in any way, it has to go back to the 150.
Right, we can put that stipulation in.
That's what I'm saying. And if they want it bigger, come in and ask and justify why you'd want it bigger for someone else. I know they cost you a big space, so they're fine.
Well, we've asked for some copy change here because we, you know, urban air, for example, that's one thing, which I understand your point. But a lot of these other businesses, you know, if you have a big mural and you have a picture here, and then you're going to, if we change tenants, and so then we're going to bring it down to some smaller sign for every time we have a tenant change. You
so
know
what you were saying to bring it down?
I would say anything that's over 150 needs to come back.
No, if it's 150, it stays at 150.
No, he's saying there's a few that are larger than 150. There's a bunch that are very close.
Are you saying bringing those larger ones down to 150?
We have to set a standard. I'm just throwing something out for discussion purposes. At what point, when, you know, some of these signs are, you know, 185, that's very close. But you've got one at, you know, 260.
Are you saying, like with urban air, if they were to leave, then we would actually ask them to divide it into two to provide more space for other tenants? So we cut that
the
in
reason
half.
You said you wouldn't make them repaint it is because it's up.
It's up, right.
Okay, so my point is, if they have to repaint it because they have to repaint it, shouldn't it be repainted on one of
ordinance
says it's 150?
You're saying if it's over 150, come back to us.
Yes.
Okay, I understand that.
Yeah.
Do we want to put any verbiage in there?
The other one, it's the 380, the one that's 380. That's the other one that's quite large.
You know.
There's really just those two.
I mean, if someone else comes in, it'll be a different perspective anyway, so I understand your point. You know, as we go through these signs too, the goal of this for both parties is that, you know, if it's approved, if we're able to change copy on most of these within the confines of what's approved, that we don't have to come back for variance and, you know, we're not.
But I think what we're talking about is stipulating a couple, there's two of them that are concerned to us.
That would be the AB, the Legacy Ignite sign, and AK. For me, if the rest were replaced and stayed within the original window that they're in, whatever size that is,
okay,
and they stay within the envelope, I wouldn't have a problem. For me personally, I would like to see then the Legacy and the Urban Air go down to the 150. Now, should you add more doors and more tenants, if you come back to change that, you may have justification to say, we have this, so let me go back to the size. I'm not going to add more signage for those. So
I'm going to throw something else into the pot.
Okay.
Good
boy.
Okay. Now you got kids jumping. Is that related to Urban Air? And if Urban Air leaves, does the kids jumping come down because it's no longer part of the Legacy Center?
Well, that's what I was starting to ask. Do we want to put verbiage in? Because,
yeah,
like,
I asked
with
the first, I'm sorry.
With the with the girl, the gymnastics next to the energy zone.
Well,
same thing.
We would paint something within that space, you know. And so, if you have a new tenant that's taking 35,000 square feet or whatever that space, you know, the building also kind of. And staying with the design of the building and the character of the building, to have big murals over here and then have a 150 square foot sign next to it would be pretty odd.
Well, but the murals are what caught my attention, not as much as 150 foot signs.
That's correct.
Okay, so I mean, that's what's captured a lot of these people over here on this document, you know, that they all signed off on. I mean, they see those big murals. And that's the people I've talked to.
Sure.
Let's go to your point, Callie, related to signage and the ones that are. I don't find the Legacy Ignite that concerning to me. I do agree with you related to the Urban Air.
My principle is the signage. If we're really trying to be consistent and fair to other property owners, other businesses, if we're limiting it everyone to 150, I think when these get replaced.
I think Urban Air needs to be addressed when it gets replaced. And if they want to go above 150, they need to come back and seek a variance.
Right, but the Legacy
that's my personal opinion.
Is more than twice the size of what would be allowed to be.
That's my personal opinion.
Which ones?
Just Urban Air. Urban Air is the only one that really concerns
me. Yeah, to me personally, anything that's that big, like the Legacy Ignite, I'm having a problem with.
That's another question. What is Legacy Ignite? I mean, I've seen the sign, but I haven't seen any advertising for it. What is Legacy Ignite?
Well, Legacy Ignite represents the entrepreneurial side of the building. So we have a young kid who wants to put a maker space. He's in the robotics club. And so they have the ability to come in, negotiate a deal with a month-to-month lease or a short-term lease. You know, we'll co-invest in their business and, you know, get them started in, you know, in their new entity. So it's kind of a entrepreneurial startup for young entrepreneurs.
Okay, thank you.
Related to the west elevation, and I think comments made by this board related to changing of AP and AR to a mural. Are you okay with that?
I'm not saying I like all the number of murals on that side either. I want to talk signs first.
Okay.
And murals. I'm not comfortable with how much is going back here from the comments from the community that live behind it.
Okay. So I guess we still need to continue our discussion related to the signage that are over 150 square feet. The ones that you have pointed out are the Legacy Ignite and the Urban Air.
Those are all on the east side though, correct? She's talking about the west side.
No, the east side is the legacy. The south side is the urban air.
But for me, I'm saying eliminate the signs on the north and west side. The two that abut subdivisions, I want no signs there.
Well,
they abut a residential area. I don't think there's a reason for a sign on those two frontage. I don't have a problem with signs on the east. I don't have a problem with signs on the south.
You can see those signs from the highway. If someone leases that space, you know, on the north side coming, which is all the traffic coming south on Lapeer Road, can definitely see those signs. And honestly, if you look at how that building is angled, that face is really not facing the condos. You want to look up the...
And we have a lot more clear sign restrictions abutting a residential, and that's why I'm saying that.
Mm-hmm. I understand where you're going.
I counted 12 signs greater than 150 square feet. The rest, 15, are less than 150.
Yeah. And like I say, I don't have a problem with the rest. They're close enough that would be my variance, that I'd allow those variations. But I would just think that we'd want to move towards saying 150, and then if circumstances change within the building where they have more tenants and they need more doors and more private entrances, they could combine, say I'm going to combine two murals into that to make it larger. But I think that for fairness to the other businesses, I'd like to at least work towards something that's
right. And typically for us, for signage, there are on corner particular lots, you're allowed to have two signs.
Right. Yeah, or just a real large building has a lot going on, like some of the buildings that we have.
Because I think Meyer came in for a variance for their signage.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they did.
Yep.
When they redid that store, when they remodeled that store,
right,
they came in for signage because they wanted the entrances distinct.
Right. So, yeah, we're...
But they also have the ability to put signage on a... You know, the only place we can put a sign is on the building.
They're a lot farther away from the highway, too.
Thoughts about?
And rough signs.
Mr. Bailey, thoughts about the signage question on the faces of the building there, face residential?
I don't see a value in having a sign facing that backside.
Let me ask this. Do you have parking on that backside on the lakeside there for those particular businesses? Do they come around? Can people drive around and park there?
Yeah, currently, it's half paved and half dirt. So there are people, like, for example, on CrossFit, that's their entrance. So people come around the building, and that's their side. And we will segment, you know, you'll have tenants in the middle, tenants on each side of the building. So... You know, there are tenants that will be facing that west side, and so they're going to need some sort of representation. Now,
what are you doing with regards to that parking? I know you haven't finished things up at the Planning Commission yet.
That's true.
Is there going to be more parking there?
It depends on what type of tenants come in. If
you've already got CrossFit in there, correct?
That's correct.
Okay.
So there is some parking. There's, you know, half of that is pavement back there.
Can we stipulate a certain...
Part of that on the west side is parking? On the north side, you've got a loading zone.
Up by the office areas.
Yeah, there's
up
like...
on the north side there on the
there's
west
a loading zone. There's no...
Yeah, there's parking around the back.
There's a small parking like where the wetlands is through there, but it's just in that one...
That's what we're referring to.
...corner. And then the rest, the building is right up off to the edge. You can't even drive back there.
No, that's not true. I think we did a...
I can pull up the aerial. There's no way you can drive across from the north to the south.
And that's you're talking
on the west side of the building where the washout is. There's no way you can take a view. It's washout.
That's not what we're referring to, though. We're not projecting any signs where the west side where there's just a little bit of walkway. Is that what you're referring to? Where the washout is? There's no signage there. This signage is. If you're standing at CrossFit, it's right to your right.
Mm-hmm.
So there, you're 100% right, Kelly. There's no need for signs where the washout is because there's only a little walkway. But yeah. Before that is what we're talking about.
And I'm willing to work with you on it. I think that for the north side, respectfully, so I don't know if you want me to refer to.
Sure, please.
Maybe it's easier.
Please.
A203.
Okay.
So A203 and AW, that building that actually faces, adjacent to the highway. So, that's important for a business that leases that space. People can see who they are, where they're coming from. And it really doesn't face
the community. The community is kind of in the back there, so they're not staring at a sign. They may see the signs if they pull up onto 24, but that's not right in front of their field of view. On the back side, on the west side, which is where CrossFit is, and so if you're coming around the north and you're just turning that corner, that's all the space that's kind of, it's still empty. And we have potential tenants, like I said, some people may want all that space. We might have three or four people sharing that. So the potential in the future, although it's not paved now, we may pave it in the near future depending on what the tenant is. And there's some parking back there, so people would come around that side of the building and access it, and they would have their entrance that way. Now, it doesn't have to be, to your point, it doesn't have to be big. So, we want to be respectful to our tenants or to our neighbors on that west side. So we don't have to have a giant mural or, unless there's something that they would enjoy. And they did come up here in our last meeting, by the way. I have a picture here. Would that be helpful? Sure.
Correlating, you're talking there and there. There's your
this is west.
Corner, your back side, and then you're looking at
that
side here. This is the loading zone. That's what I'm saying. You can't get from here to here that part,
right.
But you can get in. Well, it's kind of narrow. This is the wash. You can get into this area.
Is this the loading dock you're showing over here?
This is the loading dock here.
Yep.
Yeah, I have the aerial.
To the west.
So that's this.
There's splash here. So here's that.
You can't do anything. This aerial shows a lot better. It's so from the parking lot. Here, this is loading. All in here, you can't. You can park in here, but there's no parking there. This is totally.
We're talking about where's this area over here with all the dirt.
This is dirt.
You got some parking right over here.
Yeah, this is
the
big
one.
Those are splashes.
Yeah. So we're not asking for any signage here. It would just be, we have a long building here, and there's a big door. So we had four.
That's where the four.
Yeah.
But.
And one was a mural. There were two signs and then two murals on that side.
This is basically
a sign.
Here, this is a raised
sign.
Mm-hmm.
Let me face the north.
You got sign, sign. The condos don't start till about here, but of course, there's over here. They all face that way. And they sit way, way down.
Yep.
Thank you.
Yeah, I was concerned with this area too on the west side, but this is going to be mirrored through here.
So. Comments, questions?
We discussed lighting of the murals too. I know we kind of talked about it last time, but then again, that's not on the record. Your plans to light the sides?
We have a, we do have a lighting plan that we're submitting, for the site plan.
Commission, if they need to come in for something later?
Well, it makes a difference to me if we're lighting the back sides that are facing the residential areas. I would be very adamantly opposed to it. And Stony Lake looks right across the north side. You know, you can see the view from there.
All of our lighting that we're proposing has eyelids, and it only goes out a few, you know, a few feet to light, like the walkways and where you would park. Nothing would be protruding into our, to our, to anyone, our neighbors. So it's not a bright light that's coming this way, or so. It, and it's really just whatever. Most of the building has current lighting on it, you know, just to light the parking lot. So most of it, we're just rebuilding those lights and putting them in. But we're making sure that all of those lights are, you know, facing down. And there's an example of it, Kelly. We put one up. It's right in front of, like, the east entrance, because we wanted to test and make sure it wasn't blinding anybody. So, and we have a pretty good relationship with our neighbors. You know, they came in support of this in the last meeting, and you know, we're grateful for the things that they've done as it relates to our water suppression. So, you know, we're not going to do anything to make people upset back there.
Well, that was one of their concerns last time, was light, if it's going to light up their neighborhood.
Yeah, that was
there's some old lights that are up there that are like giant, you know. Yeah, well, I don't think they point at them. I've never seen them on, but they're pretty significant.
Says that the use of, I'm just looking at our design standards and our sign ordinance, and it says that, you know, shall be non-glaring, shall not project into adjoining properties or thoroughfares, and shall not exceed 15-foot candles measured perpendicular to the sign at 4 feet. How do you measure that from a wall sign? Just standing 4 feet from the wall?
Yeah.
And it can't exceed 15-foot candles.
Right. That's actually in their favor, really.
So I would want to make sure that, you know, anything we do, they're still going to
meet their requirement.
Comply.
Yep,
yeah,
I'll agree with you.
Well, I think in our motion, we could probably state that they take that back to the Planning Commission, that they abide by what's in the
any of the remaining standards. Provisions?
Yeah.
Any other questions, comments, concerns?
The Planning Commission's probably got a ton of stuff they still want to go over to get the final site plan.
Right. And lighting is there, is in their purview. Else,
yeah.
Lighting is in their purview.
Yep.
Any other questions, comments?
Any comment on the public entrance? Is, are we looking at a public entrance on the west side of a building that may potentially have a signage or square footage signage on anywhere, any wall on that building? We're looking at, they're talking about 24, I got the right, public doors, right? We're giving them, we're looking at a variance for square footage on those 24 doors throughout the entire wall surface. We're not looking at each north, south, east,
well, but if it is 24, it's times 150, that's 3,600 square feet.
That's pretty close to the total of what they're looking, right? Yes. 2,800?
Yes, if it's 24 doors.
But all 24, yeah. My point is there's not 24 doors on one wall.
No.
There may only be 12 doors on one,
correct,
one,
well,
wall.
Well, I'm going to go by devil's advocate here. He said there's 19 tenants, so we have 19 times 15, assuming everyone has their own private entrance. 19 times 150.
Okay.
That's what would be allowed if there was 19 tenants.
Currently, yeah. I mean,
yeah.
They're talking 24.
24, yeah, potential.
Because before you said 11 doors, we were calculating based on 11 doors and 19 tenants. So if you say all 19 tenants have their own exclusive entrance, each would be allowed 150.
Want to throw some more mud into the soup? Well, how about each one of these doors that have signage on them about? I mean, isn't that considered signage as well?
There's windows there. There's windows, too.
Windows as well?
We have window signage as well on some of them.
Or do we just want to rule on what we currently have today?
Call it 19. Call it 19.
That's what we can do, yeah.
Call it 19.
We're specifically looking at wall signs.
So that would be 2850.
2850, the variance would be 950 square feet.
Your tenants that there can't be anything on the door, and if they want something, you're going to have to come back, and we're going to have to look at this again. I mean, because I'm looking at some of these doors, and they, what's the one that went to soup, and they do all different kinds of...
They have hours of operation listed on there.
That's true, but I've got pictures that show this one facility that's got all different kinds of good stuff on there. Maybe... Let's go widen this up. Okay, suite 123, Feel Your Life Cafe, Java Juice, Cuisine, and Cook School. On top of their phone number and hours of operation. So, I mean, the entire door is virtually taken up with stuff. So, I mean...
I think that she put that sign on her door for...
This is actually labeled on. I mean, this is that he's. Well, it, you know, so I mean, it,
yeah.
But we have to look at that as signage too. So we know what you've got, but all this applies to your building, okay? They're going to come in later on and ask us for more square footage for all these signs on the doors and other signs for entrance, egress, or whatever.
If it has just hours of operation, suite number, those are not regulated by us.
Yeah.
Okay. If it has the name of the business, Callie, would it be?
What's that?
The applique is each individual door, each individual suite. They have hours of operation, things like that, on their door and suite number, identifying that door.
This is suite.
If you look at this.
Hours of operation.
Is that part of our ordinance?
We talked about that last time, didn't we?
Yeah.
I think the ordinance. I'm
trying to remember, it was 9.7J.
We have a window sign.
Not to exceed 25%.
25% of the window area.
Of the window area.
That was 20.
So we're happy to monitor that with our tenants.
Temporary permanent window sign shall be permanent outside.
Yeah, we need to go back to that tenant and make sure it fits within those guidelines.
My request was to have everything on the doors and windows.
Does that include the hours of operation, phone number, email address?
They can put what they want on it.
25%.
As long as it doesn't exceed 25%.
Okay. Now, what does code call for if there is an emergency contact information? Does that information have to be on the front of that door, too?
The suite number.
Just the suite number?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the main address.
Okay. Yeah, that covers it, as long as it doesn't exceed that. Any other questions?
I want to get it all out now.
No, it's all good. Questions, comments? Not, I'd like to... I didn't...
What were you going to do?
I was going to open the public comment section.
Good, because I need some time to process, too.
All right, you process.
Okay.
It is now 8:37. I would like to open up the public hearing for anyone who would like to come forward and speak on this matter. Feel free to do so. If not, it is 8:37, and I will close the public hearing and bring it back to us.
Bring it back to us? You can stay up there, Mr. Friedman.
I didn't know if someone was coming up.
Oh, we just want to make sure that we covered anybody in the back there.
You came up with 3,800?
3,800.
Okay.
3,800, yeah.
So, any other questions, any comments for Mr. Mills? If not, I will entertain a motion.
Can we take just a two-minute recess to just process the information?
Yeah, let's take a two-minute recess.
Two-minute recess.
You wouldn't mind?
Thank you. I take it you're going to make the motion?
We are reconvened. We're in the process of making a motion.
All right, I'm going to
take a motion.
I'm going to take a stab at this. So okay. I would move that ZBA 007.16 for the parcel known to us today as the Legacy Center.
Okay.
Based on our findings and discussion we have determined that we have classified these into signs and murals. Murals consist of the artwork and are not included in this motion and will be addressed in a separate motion. We have determined that there are, I just lost count on my number of signs. I'm going to fill in the blank on the number of signs. We'll check that. If you want to just count the...
27.
Not everything from here, up. Just count the number of hatches from there.
Okay,
so he's going to fill in the number of signs. We've determined that there are that number of signs. We've determined...
21.
Okay, that there are 21 signs. And 19 tenants having 24 public access doors. This information having been provided to us by the applicant. The current ordinance, we have determined, would allow approximately, would allow the 19 tenants to have 150 square feet of signage per tenant, which would result in 2,850 square feet. The petitioner has requested 3,800 square feet in signage, which would require a 950 square foot variance. I am moving that we grant this 950 square foot variance, and that variance also includes a variance on the maximum individual sign square feet allowed and height to reflect exactly the elevation submitted in the plans today. Door and window signage is not included in this calculation and shall meet all township ordinance. All other signage is to comply, and signage issues is to comply and must be approved by the Planning Commission or township. Should the signs identified as AB, which is Legacy Ignite, and AK, Urban Air, be altered or changed from their exact appearance, the new allowed signage area shall not exceed 150 square feet. Should the information presented regarding the number of public access points or tenants be deemed incorrect, the matter will return to the Zoning Board of Appeals for further deliberation and determination.
Is there a second?
I'll second the motion.
Discussion on motion.
And the last part might be clear, but basically if there was an error that we find out, when this goes back and you submit it, if all of a sudden you figure there's a wrong amount of doors, if it's more, it probably shouldn't be a problem. If it's less, then it gives the board a chance to just kind of say, we're okay with it, or something needs to change.
Would the maker motion include that he needs to apply to come back to the Zoning Board of Appeals?
No.
That's just an open...
Should... Then I said should the information presented regarding the number, okay, how about I do this? Should the I will amend my motion to say, should the township determine that the number of current tenants and the number of current access doors is not correct, it will be returned. The matter, the variance is put on stay until they return to the planning or to the zoning board for.
But doesn't that open? That leaves it open ended. That he could just come, it's not an open invitation to come back, he would need to apply to come back here.
You're saying for cost?
Yeah, for cost.
Right.
I can just add in there, let's see, the matter will be, that the township will then, okay, I'll amend the motion to say, should the information presented, should the township determine that the information presented regarding the number of public access points, doors, or tenants is incorrect, the township will immediately direct the matter back to the Zoning Board of Appeals, and the petitioner will bear the cost, and the current ZBA variance is stayed until conclusion of that.
I'll second that.
One other point I want to bring up. I think for the purposes of just sheer code enforcement, we need to update this plan. This plan needs to be updated, determined clearly what's a logo.
Okay. I was going to do...
And what's a sign?
And I'm going to do logos on a second, Mr. Smith. And, okay, I will amend my motion, because I can just very quickly, for the record, read off what we've considered a sign by doing the sign designation. Okay, I will do that. I will amend my motion.
Do we want to submit his plan into the...
We are definitely going to sign it.
Well, I would like, sign to return to us. I would be willing to review it, make sure it's consistent, and that would be the approved plan that we have in the file. There's no plan. It has somebody scratched something on it someday back in whatever.
Right.
Yep.
Well, I'm really just, if you want to, I'll amend my motion that we're determining that what the zoning board has determined as signs are D, paper, it's so hard to line up. Yes, B, D like David.
Yep.
E.
Yep.
Edward. F, Frank.
Yes.
L.
G.
P as in Paul.
G. As in George.
G.
Oh, your life's cafe.
Oh.
G.
That was the missing 50. There we go. Okay. G as in George.
Your hatch. L.
L is in Larry. P is in Paul. Q is in Queen. R is in Robert. S is in Sam. We've determined that T and U are actually the same, designating the same
yes.
sign. And that is a sign. V as in Victor, W as in William, X as in X-ray, Y, we got that one clear, Z, double A, AB, AC, AE, AH, AK.
AL.
What have we got here? AL. And I just realized I missed a component in there. And I'm also amending my motion that there will be no signage on the west and north elevations.
Then we really need to work the entire quantity to do that.
Pardon?
We would need to rework the entire quantity.
I did. That's how I did my quantity. My math was based on omitting those.
So that means we have an addition of 2 to the number I gave you previously when you had me add these up.
So we've got 1, 2.
You told me from AK North.
I have 23.
Okay. What did I give you before?
24.
So I will amend that.
No, 24 access points, but
21 signs.
Yeah, 21, yeah.
So it's 23 signs?
23.
Yes.
Yep. 23 signs.
Can I?
We're in the middle of a motion, so no.
Okay.
Sorry.
Okay. So we're allowing the 23 signs that we just named off.
Go with the number 23. Good?
Yeah. Yes. Good.
Okay. Second on that motion?
Second.
Any discussion on that motion?
We create another motion to include the west and the north.
I was going to address the murals. My motion said that we're going to address the murals.
The murals will be separate.
Okay.
Separately.
Okay.
We're talking about signage, yeah.
Signage only. And what this does is... we have 19. We're saying there's 19.
We identified
signs,
all the signs, even the ones we're not
right.
That I don't have in my motion.
So we're granting a variance of 950 square feet, which eliminate signage from the west side.
The north and west.
And from the north side.
Which are four total signs.
Which are four signs. Any other discussion on the matter? Roll call. Vote. Secretary.
Secretary.
You?
I don't think so.
Vice Chair.
And Tim. You're Secretary, right?
I am, no.
You are. Kelly.
Oh, is that me?
Kelly, you.
I didn't think I was.
So I said.
Wow.
So I said Kelly.
Well, I don't want this chair. I didn't think I was.
Nope, that's you.
Okay. Well, I can't do it. I made the motion. Benikowski? Benikowski?
Yes.
Walters?
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
So, Rosner, yes. Butler?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to do it in the right order. Okay, take carries.
Part one, signage.
I think we get signage.
Do a second motion.
I'm going to just do a quick discussion on just murals before I make a motion. The only one that concerns me is really the amount of murals on the back that we're not seeing. And the amount of murals that they actually want to add. I really need to visualize the blank spaces that are going to be murals and really kind of see.
Backside being the west.
The west?
Yeah.
The 2,000 square foot.
Well, not just the west. And just quickly look at all the faces as a board and just, I know when the public spoke, they're seeing the murals that are there. I want to really visualize how many more are going to be there to get a feeling if, you know, that same semblance, you know, might be there. And I've really just so focused on signs, I didn't really just look at that.
And we want to put that into the motion that particular mural go before the Planning Commission to review for...
Well, I'm looking to see how many we're adding.
That way they wouldn't have to come back at a cost to us. That's just one large...
Well, right now you've taken out AP and AR. We've taken out AP and AR.
You're adding...
So if those are no longer signs...
Because you're talking about murals, right?
No. I'm looking at murals. AP, AQ would be a mural.
Are you looking at the last of the back?
I'm looking at the west.
Side?
There's five murals.
I was just
going to
start with the east
one,
side and
two,
work my way.
One, two, three, four, five.
There's five.
There's five murals on the back.
I think that big one there is.
Then there's two on indoor.
Once again, when we were talking before about that one, the Legacy Center, Ignite, Legacy Ignite. And the other one, this one wasn't brought into play because of its size. It was still open.
It's a mural.
Well, it's a mural versus sign.
It's not a sign.
I know, a mural, but I mean, and Kelly wants to know what's going to go into that mural area.
I guess this is the way I see it. We kind of know aesthetically what's there, and we're comfortable with it. There's quite a bit of area where we're just not really seeing what's going to go there yet. And are we comfortable just saying, okay, here's a blank, fill it in? Or is it something we should say on these ones that aren't filled in, should we just send it back to Planning Commission for them to look at it? Which I would be comfortable with doing.
AR, I'm not as concerned with, because we've got it defined in square footage. And when we're looking down here as far as square footage goes, on the back side of that big blue area, there's nothing defined in there, it's just a big open canvas.
With you, Larry, I'm comfortable with the smaller ones. Yeah. The bigger one, I think, probably needs some to know what that's going to be.
I think that's Callie's concern as well.
She can speak for herself.
Yeah, I mean, on the east side, which is, you know, the 24 frontage, there's one...
On the front,
besides the smaller one, which I consider like signage.
There's one more to be added on the front. Mm-hmm. On the Lapeer Road M24 frontage, there's one more to be added mural. On the back, there's three more.
Yeah, so I guess...
And I'm not concerned about the smaller of the two in the back.
Yeah, for me, it's the big one.
The big one, I think, needs to...
Yeah.
Some definition.
Have some definition. So I think that needs to be... That's a Planning Commission action, correct?
I would be
comfortable. Leave it as what's up is up, and anything else has Planning Commission needs to
We don't know what's...
Pull that along with the shrubbery and everything else and landscaping. Can you bring it up to them? Then if they needed a variance because they didn't get what they want from the...
They always come back.
Right.
Nothing's precluding them from ever coming back.
Yeah, I mean, I'm comfortable with everything. Except for, you know, AU, I'd really like somebody to review that.
So AU is the large...
The large one
on the blue wall.
What about if we brought that size down a little bit, cut it in sections or cut it in half?
I guess what my point is it would go to Planning Commission to make sure that they didn't see anything wrong with it, and it would just be approved through your site plan process.
But the we don't know what's going there, so the site plan, it's the same conversation that we're going to have at the site plan that we're having here. You know, so they're going to, you know, approve or not approve.
You want to break it down now, give us three or four boxes instead of just the one big one?
That would be, I would, sure.
Three. Can you do that now?
Yes.
Three at one time.
At that same size, the 216?
216.
You know, the vision there is really to, you know, it's kind of designed for an ocean to have a rock and a shark and something like that. Mm-hmm. So, but I'm not going to stand on this issue if there's some comfort level. If you could break it down, maybe shrink it this way, in an area that gives you comfort, or, you know, I'm happy to
get through this process.
Not more, seeing what it is.
You can always come back if you needed.
Yeah, I wouldn't have a problem with the three if they were consistent with the size of the others.
It really...
Does that work?
I have pictures of what it could look like.
Do you?
But it's
I'd like to kind of visualize what you're anticipating going there.
Okay.
We won't hold it to it.
I mean, if it's swimmers swimming down a lane, that might be interesting.
You know,
so it's like, what are we going to do?
The idea is it's like an ocean theme, right? So we painted the top dark.
A shark and the surfer or something.
We want kids to, like, come around, or if the grandparents are bringing the kids, and, like, for them to want to check this out,
yeah,
kind of idea. And
good.
So, you know, we had an idea of a, you know, like a shark on one side, or a whale shark with some fish swimming into its mouth, and, you know, just some tasteful sea life.
Okay.
So that was the purpose of that mural. And, you know, so...
So you're going to have to put 1,000 fish into one of those little boxes there.
Probably. But, you know, we wanted to do something very tasteful and...
Yeah. So you didn't want to be confined to three separate boxes that we put on paper right now with an ink pen, as opposed to having that area to make it look more natural and flow.
To be able to work with, yes. Okay.
I think I'd like to see it shrunk down. That's a big percentage of that building face. It can be long.
50%.
But I would like to see that smaller and less a big function of the side of that building.
You know, it's on the west side.
I thought there was windows on that side. That
it's residential.
No, that's all blocked.
All
you don't see it. You cannot see this from the residential.
You can't see it from Market Street.
It's easier Market.
I know coming down Market, I can see it real clear. I go all, you know, I go over to Myers Avenue.
But you'd have to, residential speaking,
residential.
The first home isn't all the way down until you're past the peak, number one hole in the piece.
It's because this is high, you can see it. That's why, it's because it's way up.
But it fronts also on commercial development, too. Market Street.
Well,
properties are commercial.
And
that's Market, but I've driven back there into the
Stony
subdivision
Lake,
and looking,
right,
and I mean, it is really.
We would, we could also limit the height, because really the sea life is going to be below the blue line. So we could bring it down a little bit, too. Maybe that's a good compromise.
20%, 15%, 10%, 5%. That's the height right now.
Yeah, if we want to get through this, I mean, do we have a number we want to put to it? Put a number to it, and I mean, if you think you need something different, there's always the opportunity.
Right now, it's 2,000 square feet.
Bring it down to 1,500 square feet.
That's
comfortable.
Kelly?
Yeah, that should shrink it.
You want to shrink it this way or this way?
Well, I mean, it's going to shrink it one way or the other, and I think it'll make it work. Yeah, I would like to see it come down a little bit. A little bit of both ways would be fine.
My suspicion.
I mean, the whale fitting in this side over here at the same height as, you know, someone, a boat or a fish might not be proportional. They may want to go a little bit larger on the one side with the whale, then smaller on the other side with the fish. And
1,500 square feet.
No. I can live with that.
Okay.
Can you live with 1,500 square foot?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So, with that, I will entertain a motion.
Hey, I did one. I can make a motion.
You're so good at it, Ken.
All right. Again, I'll repeat. ZBA 007.16 for the property known to us as the Legacy Center. This motion, I make this motion in regards to the murals. We've done a previous motion for the signage. The murals are what are identified on the plans that will be kept with the file as anything other than what we have previously identified in our motion for signs. I would grant that they would be allowed to put the murals in the areas indicated and keep the murals that are already there. With the change of mural, give me the number on that one again, is that AU?
Yes.
Where the request was for 2,000 square feet, we are going to change that to 1,500 square feet. I think that's all I need
in that one. In accordance with findings of facts?
And that is based on our discussion and findings of fact. Thank you.
Okay.
Do we have a second?
And do we want to add once again in?
Do I have a second?
Okay. Second.
Okay. Now we just
I figured we'd work on it a little bit.
Larry.
And in the revised, you're going to bring us some revision to this? It'll show 1,500 square foot on that one mural?
That's not in my motion.
Okay. They'll bring it in.
Okay. So you're saying to... Okay. I'll amend my motion that the applicant will submit...
There we go.
A revised plan.
Elevation indicating the size and location of AU. I believe it was AU, right? Make sure I get that right again.
Split.
Of AU.
And then the removal of the
and it's reconfigured 1,500 square feet.
And we also have some signs that we removed from the west and the north elevations.
That was in the sign ordinance, they weren't allowed?
Well, I want the plan to show
Okay. Exactly
what it's to show.
Okay, that's great. And then I will amend my motion that when the elevations come back, that the what had been labeled as signage for AP, AR, AV, and AW will be removed.
So a second.
Second. Larry.
Larry. Any other discussion on this, Mr. Bailey, Mr. Walters?
Nope.
All comfortable?
I am. I know in the previous motion for the signage, we talked about Legacy Center and that, and we're not considering that to be a mural, correct? I mean for the kids.
It's all count. Which one?
Okay.
It's counted in the signs.
Okay, yeah. That's all included in the signs.
Yeah, it's included.
Okay. Yeah. That's my end of discussion.
Either a mural or a sign.
I wanted to make sure we were covered.
Okay. Okay. No, we're okay. Covered. We're good.
All right.
Madam Secretary,
call the room.
Call the matter.
Bailey?
Yes.
Vanachowski?
Yes.
Walters?
Yep.
Rosner, yes. Butler?
Yes. Every variance.
Do you understand it?
Okay, I do have a question as it relates to the signage on the north side. So, how do we, if we have businesses that are facing the north, how do we represent, you know, those people on the north side? Because we had the two signs that are just facing the highway, and so those will be potentially separate units.
Nothing precludes you from coming back.
When there's a site plan and you have an entrance and a parking lot and all that, nothing stopping you from
coming back
and saying
you
need to identify those.
Okay, so if we had some more businesses back there...
Come back in.
Okay. Okay.
Then you get 150 square foot, right?
Take it one step at a time.
So we can do 150. We don't, without a variance on those, we just need to ask for a variance over 150 on the north and west side.
Are those on the plan right now?
No.
Okay, then you're going to have to come back because you're going to take you over what we've already given you.
Okay.
Yeah. That'll change the variance.
That'll change it.
Okay. Even though it complies.
Okay. So for those units, we'll have to come back and
you will.
For any signage on the west side.
Well, you're allowed a door sign. I mean, you're allowed the door and the window sign that you have that would have it. Yeah, so if there's a door or a window, you can
window
have
sign.
It.
But as far as a signage above the building,
right?
Yes, you'd have to come back.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you for your patience. Appreciate it.
Thank you,
ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. I think you've been more than fair, and we appreciate consideration. And you know, we're working through this process, even though at some points it feels like it's maybe after the fact.
No, you've been very good, and it's a great center to have, and it's a
I hope certainly you succeed.
Yeah, it's a tremendous amenity to the community for sure. Thank you for doing that.
Thank you.
Appreciate that. Okay, moving on to board member comments. Any comments from board members?
No.
I'll entertain a motion for adjournment.
Motion to adjourn.
Support.
Motion support. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? We done.